Come along with me today, guys, as we head to Camila's Kitchen, and this is located at 6 Skyline Drive in Kingston. Now, Camila is pretty much a vegan. She does a lot of healthy lifestyle foods, you know, a lot of vegetarian foods, a lot of actually really nice, you know, tasty looking foods that a lot of people would say that, you know, vegan food is boring, and she brings life to her food. Now, I've seen her all over social media. I've seen, you know, the raves, and I'm not a vegan, but I do eat clean. At least, let's say, you know, 75-80% of the time I do eat clean. So this was somewhere that I was looking forward to go to see what she has to offer, what's on the menu. And I also heard that the view is like breathtaking. So right now we're headed, you know, up to Papin, because her restaurant is actually located past Papin, going up to Skyline Drive. Now, if you are in the Kingston environs, you're actually closer, because, you know, well, I'm coming from St. Catherine, Spanish Town, and, you know, it's a journey, but we got there. So currently we're in Papin, right? And yes, it's a busy town. You can see people shopping and taxis, and the rain was also falling on this day as well. So yeah, the umbrellas were out. But as you can see, the clouds in the background there, you know, yeah, the weather wasn't the best that day. But we were still on our journey to find Camila's Kitchen, because, you know, she's into healthy lifestyle. She is one of my motivator, you know, when it comes to, you know, eating good and taking care of your health. So I've always been, you know, watching her and following her on her journey. And I wanted to go and support and see what her restaurant is all about. So right now we're, as I said, we're going through Papin and we're heading up to Skyline Drive. It's way on top of those mountains that you're seeing there. Yes, it's on top of the mountains. You're gonna see a beautiful view. I mean, you could only imagine from on top of the mountains. So right now we're actually turning into Skyline Drive. So if you're coming from Papin side, you're swinging left, you'll see the sign right there. And yes, this is us going up on top of the hills. Now, I must say this, you've journeyed along with me, you know, throughout this journey of me showing you guys a lot of places. And you've noticed that we've been through a lot of greenery. Like, I'm always going to these places that, you know, there's a lot of bushes and grass and trees growing on the sides of the roads. But this was different. It was in Kingston. This is in Kingston. We're not in the country, but this is the place where a lot of people come when they want to see the view, you know, overseeing Kingston. You know, this is one of the places that people come to, you know, and the roads are narrow. This is my first time coming here. And it's different because I never knew, like, Kingston had all this, you know, this vibe. It's giving a country vibe. But it's a good country vibe that it's giving me, because I know that we're going to be, you know, coming up to something really great in the end. Like, this is what life is about. Like, I'm on the top of the world right now. I'm on top of the world, literally. Okay then. Thinking too. Very fast. So as you can see, guys, we made it to Camila's Kitchen. That's the sign on the gate right there, telling you about the opening hours and stuff like that. Now, as you enter, you're gonna see her garden. Really beautiful garden, actually, with stuff that she plants for her kitchen. Guys, this is Camila's Kitchen, you know. Okay, so this is located in Skyline Drive, guys, and this is like past Papin. Look, there's pure avocado on the tree right here. Like, there's avocados growing on the tree. It's very fruitful and nice, guys. And this is up in the hills. If you're coming and you want some nice vegan food, or you want some nice, you know, yeah, vegetarian food, I'm telling you, this is a place you need to be.
Good day.
Welcome to Camila's kitchen.
Hi.
It's nice.
Now, if you're a nature lover like me, you're gonna definitely like this spot. It is giving greenery, as you could see. The ambience of the place is everything. You're overlooking the view of the entire city. There's trees, there are ackee trees, avocado trees, breadfruit trees, everything growing right there in the restaurant, well, in the yard. And she also has a bar right there. And you know, you could get your natural juices, which we're gonna try out as well. And even the table, like, look at the, you know, this is naturally made, like the straws and the art and craft. The vibe of the place is different from any regular restaurant that you would go. It's giving you homely and it's giving you a vintage vibe. Obviously, you know, it's giving you retroactive vibe. It's giving you a little piece of Jamaica, the Rasta colors. It's nice. It's different. And I like that. Now, it was a Saturday and we were feeling for some soup. So they did say that they have soup on the menu.
Oh, wow. It smells so good. Thank you.
So, yes, there was vegan soup on the menu. And I'm telling you, the soup smelled good from a mile away. Like, the soup smelled really good. It was rich and it was creamy. And yes.
It's the views for me, guys.
And just in case you're wondering, the soup tasted really good. The soup was really good. Now, it's just like you having you some beef soup or some chicken soup, but without the meat. It was full of, you know, it was full of vegetables. It was full of corn. It was thick, rich, and creamy. As you could see, I'm sitting down breezing out and looking at the trees below me and taking in the view. It is everything. There's a stage right there as well. They do live performances as far as I could see. Now, they also have these signature drinks that we wanted to try one out. We were getting the sorrel mint fever grass drink, all natural. So there I am trying it out.
Refreshing. Don't you know?